Have you ever heard of the Hogan twins in British Columbia? They're joined, they're co-joined twins, and their brain is linked. There's a piece of one part of the stem, I think, is linked between them, and they can tell jokes to one another with no words. Right?
Whoa.
Yeah, they can also see through one another's eyes.
So,
yeah, you should look into it. It's pretty amazing. I feel like someone that you would be interested in, if you don't know him already, is the Canadian science fiction author Peter Watts. Do you know? Have you heard of Peter Watts?
No, I haven't heard of him.
He's a hard sci-fi writer who I love his stuff. I came across it recently, and he used to be a marine biologist. So he was a scientist who got into writing science fiction novels and has an extreme understanding of evolutionary biology. He'd be very interesting to speculate on, like, what the human form would look like, you know, a few hundred generations from now.
I always felt like the aliens that you see in, like, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, that iconic shape, it's almost like we have an understanding of where we're going.
Mm. Like, some innate, like, yeah. Sort of shedding hair, everything becomes cerebral.
Yeah.
There would be a Neuralink, like, heavy... sort of brain computer interface system where everything would be you know, would allow you to go somewhere else. One of the things that Peter Watts, I'm working with him on a sci-fi idea at the moment, and one of the things that he is into is this idea that he thinks that consciousness expands to the amount of neurons that are available to it. It's like a fluid thing that moves, right? And so if you use the twins from Canada as an example, what he's saying is happening with them is the way that their brain is linked. It's the data pipe isn't fat enough, right? It's more like dial-up rather than high, you know, broadband. So if you were to increase the volume of data of information being sent between the two brains, what would happen at a certain point is the two versions of self would dissolve into one united self. And you would have one super organism that would be the consciousness of both. And if you were to somehow remove that, if you were to limit the bandwidth again, those two souls would never return. Because the way the neural system has been aligned at the point that you poured more, you allowed the consciousness to expand, it never reverts back. So you can imagine a world where, like Neuralink talks about, you know, if you fuse hundreds of brains together in some kind of hive mind and everyone can think together, what may happen is you may actually get a situation where you create a super intelligence that thinks of itself as I. And you are unable to undo that. It's sort of not clear exactly what would happen to each individual node of consciousness if you ever try to reverse it again.
Whoa.
Yeah. You know?